Good afternoon and welcome to the Hartt School presents Performing in Forward Motion. Today we're going to be with Professor Toth, head of our percussion department, and discussing Welcome to the Panyard. So can you tell us a little more about that, Professor Toth?
Absolutely. A panyard is a place, basically it's a big parking lot. It's a place where steel bands store their instruments and rehearse. I played in the 2000 Trinidad Panorama, and I rehearsed in their panyard, in a panyard there. The group I played in was called the Solo Pan Knights. And although I've been playing steel drums since 1980, I learned quite a bit on that trip. It was part of a sabbatical project that I took. So these next few minutes, I thought I would just introduce you to the idea of steel drums and panyards, and tell you a little bit about Trinidad, their carnival tradition, and steel drums themselves. So the carnival tradition is, as it is around the world, it comes from a French tradition. It's tied into the religious calendar. Carnival happens the weekend before Ash Wednesday each year. And in Trinidad, the biggest event of their carnival is their Panorama, or National Steel Band Competition. So as I said, I played in their National Steel Band Competition with a 100-piece group in 2000, and rehearsed with the group for about 5 or 6 weeks, lived on the island and rehearsed and participated with the band through the competition. So I thought I would show you my steel drum and maybe play a little bit for you. See inside a little bit, you can see that steel drum has about 32 or 33 dents in it. Each one plays a different pitch, and it's my job to memorize which dent equals which pitch. So we actually have a steel band at the Hartt School, and I thought I would maybe play you a little clip of the band. So I'm going to share my screen and show you a couple things for a moment here. First, I have a picture here. I hope you can see. I mentioned a panyard. The picture on the right here is me in the Solo Pan Knights panyard in Trinidad. I was there for the 2000 Panorama, or their 2000 Carnival. And the gentleman standing next to me is named Robbie Greenwich. He was the leader of our band, and you may know him as the steel drummer from Jimmy Buffett's group. So Robbie is known internationally and is one of the top steel drum players and arrangers on the island. Picture next to it was after the semifinal competition. This is one of my friends from the band who helped me learn the part. I arrived after they had been rehearsing for 2 months. They began rehearsing on January 2nd, preparing for the Panorama. And I showed up a couple months later, about a month and a half before Carnival. And John, this young man, helped me catch up with the rest of the group. At that point, our piece was about 18 minutes long. And of course, like in many cultures around the world, the music is learned entirely by rote. And so it was a very interesting and different process. So that's Robbie Greenwich and my buddy John from the Solo Pan Nights. I'm going to play you an example of a calypso tune that is heard on the radio and which would then be arranged for Panorama. And if you listen closely, you'll hear it's the same tune that I just played for you. So that tune that you just heard is from 1985 or 86, and it's called The Hammer. That's a song that I played for you a moment ago. And just lastly, I wanted to show you a clip of the Hartt Steel Band. We have about 20 players in our band. They're typically percussion majors, but sometimes there are other students involved. And let's play just a minute or so of this. This is from a recent concert. That was just the intro to the tune. Every year, the Hartt Steel Band plays a full Panorama length tune, a competition tune, which actually was transcribed note for note the way it's learned in Trinidad, but we learn it with music, actually, rather than by rote. So you may wonder, as a prospective student at the Hartt School, why does this matter to you? Well, one, you could come and enjoy our concerts or rehearsals. Students often hang out at rehearsals and enjoy the music. But also, we have a course called World Percussion Lab, which is offered each spring. And in that course, which I teach, I introduce the students to music from not just Trinidad, but also from Cuba, Brazil, Haiti, the Middle East, etc. And it's a hands-on class. It really is a lab where everyone gets to play on a whole variety of authentic instruments that we've imported from around the world. Also, if you're a music education major, we use all these instruments and we teach all these styles of music in the percussion methods class for both instrumental students and vocal students. So there's definitely an opportunity to integrate with the percussion studio and to participate in some of these, in some of this sort of music making. And of course, I'll look forward to seeing you at the Hartt School, and would be happy, truly, I'd be happy to show you any of these instruments during my office hours. I hope to see you there.
Thank you so much for taking the time, Professor Toth, to share this with us today. It truly was enlightening.
It's my pleasure.
Have a wonderful rest of their afternoon.